Today, I want to show you how I made a Wi-Fi remote to turn my computer on and off. I actually made this 2 years ago and I just never got around to edit it. But the good news is that, well, it's been working well and now I've tested it for 2 years. But why did I need this in the first place? Well, I mostly work from home now, but back then I had to go out for jobs at different offices. And every once in a while, I needed an asset or a file from home. And while there are tons of apps to control the computer remotely, none of them work if the computer is not turned on in the first place. So I had a few options. I could leave it on all the time, but that's pretty wasteful because I have two computers at home and sometimes I need stuff from one, sometimes I need stuff from the other. So, you know, that would be double the waste. I've also tried using Wake on LAN, which is a protocol that some computers support, but one of my computers didn't support it at the time and the one that did, I found it to not be very reliable. So eventually I figured that the best solution would be to create a little device that basically pushes the power button for me. All desktop computers have standard pins that go from the power button to the motherboard to tell it to turn on, so I can put my device in the middle and send my own signal. Sounds easy enough, so I went to my oldest computer and disconnected the cables that go from the case to the motherboard and swapped them for my own to do some tests. Since the reset button works the same way, I can also integrate that into my device. And this is great because if the machine freezes or something, I can push the reset button. I also wanted to add an input to check on the power LED. That way I can see if the machine is on or off, or even if it's asleep. Buttons are just valves for electricity, and when you press them, they allow current to flow to the motherboard. The motherboard detects that, and then it turns on. So to simulate me pushing the power button, I just need to control a switch that allows the current to flow for a second, and then turn back off. In a previous video, I connected my lock to Wi-Fi, and I used relays to do this. However, for these little voltages, they're way overkill and they're also pretty bulky, so this time instead I use optocouplers. And they're also switches, but instead of an electromagnet, they use a transistor that's sensitive to light. So when you shine light on them, they allow electricity to flow. That transistor is attached or coupled to an LED on the other side, so when you pass a small voltage on the LED, it shines the phototransistor and allows electricity to flow on the other circuit, just like a regular button. These are meant for smaller currents, and they're also way smaller than the relays, so they are perfect for this. And like the relays, they keep the motherboard circuit and the circuit for my device isolated from each other, which is why I wasn't that afraid of burning anything. You know, for the most part, I still use my oldest computer to test it. To control all of this, I used a Wemos D1 Mini, which are tiny and cheap microcontrollers, kind of like an Arduino, but with Wi-Fi, and I got two for $10 or something like that. And it took me a while to figure out how to connect it to Wi-Fi and receive commands on it. But once I did, coding the logic itself wasn't that complicated. Since I have access to the power LED of the computer, I can make a power on command that only pushes the button if the computer is off, and a power off command that only pushes the button when the computer is on. And this is much better than if I had to push the power button blindly, you know, without knowing if the computer is already on or off, because it might do the opposite of what I want. I found an app that someone made to send custom commands over Wi-Fi. That way, I can send commands whenever I want from my phone. Here, I'm testing the software. Each light represents a button, so I can visualize what's happening. The button is actually connected to the input of the computer power LED, so I can simulate the light being on or off. Here, I can send a power on signal and reset. And if I press the button, the device thinks the computer is on, so if I send the off command, it pushes the button, but if I send the on command, nothing happens. Everything seemed to be working, so I replaced the button and LEDs with the optocouplers, and after a quick test to make sure they still work, it was time to make it more permanent. It took me a few tries to find the best way I could to arrange the board, then I soldered everything together and tested it, and then I realized my soldering job was pretty crappy, this was 2 years ago, and so I fixed it. Lastly, I added a bypass for the buttons so that if I press the original power reset buttons, they bypass my device altogether and still do what they did originally, even if my device is powered off. And now it was time to connect everything and test it. And the moment of truth. And it worked. And my computer didn't burn and die, so yay. Now it's just a matter of finding a place for it inside the computer. I made a 3D printed adapter so that I could mount my device in a hard drive bay inside the computer. For power, it uses USB, so I routed the power cable through the back of the computer to a USB port on the outside. In the case of my computer, the USB ports are always powered even when the computer is off, so that works in this case. But if you're doing this and that's not the case on your computer, you can connect it to a USB phone charger or something like that. And later I found these cables that connect directly to the USB headers on my motherboard, so that's one of the options if you want to keep all the wires inside of the case. And that's it. Now I can turn on the computer through Wi-Fi. Originally, I opened a port through my router so that I could do it remotely, which is not the safest way to do it, but it works, and the little microcontroller itself can't do that much if it gets hacked, other than turning off my computer, of course. I actually removed the open port because I'm home all the time, so I haven't used it that way. So, don't try it. For the future, I've started working on encrypting the commands now. So there are actually some newer boards that came out since I made the device 2 years ago, and they can connect to the cloud more securely. So I'm looking into all those options. If you're interested in making one for yourself, I'm going to put the plans on the link below. If there's enough interest, I can look into making it a more refined, like an actual commercial product. Either way, I hope this was interesting. Subscribe if you feel like it, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.